Joining us now, Fox News digital politics editor Chris Stirewalt and host of Media Buzz right here on FNC, Howie Kurtz. Good to see you both tonight. So Wemple of the Washington Post seems to have an issue. We did that interview with those three heroes, and the feedback we received from the viewers was extraordinary. They wanted to hear more. They wanted to know how they could help these guys. They couldn't wait to see the movie. Wemple has a different reaction, which is, what did we learn that was new? I've got news for you, Eric Wemple. You go and you sit through 13 hours. You sit there, white-knuckled, when you can't move at the end of it, and a tear comes to your eye, unless you're not human. And you tell me whether this is going to have no impact on the story of Benghazi, which is relevant in this 2016 presidential campaign, Chris.
Well, there's a little pepper jelly for him. and look, the power of this movie is not that it is fact-finding. The power of this movie is not that it uncovers something that has not been uncovered before. As you say, it corroborates evidence that was in the book on which it was based. It corroborates reporting that the team at Fox News did and all of that stuff. The point of this is the audience for this compared to, say, oh, I don't know, the audience for a midday congressional hearing. Lots of people who are not politically obsessed, lots of people who are not obsessed with foreign policy, who are decent people and have real lives, are going to go see this movie. And now they're going to have a predicate for this discussion when it comes into 2016.
You know, Howie, the Fox News Channel has, I'm very proud of the reporting that we have done on Benghazi. I mean, I was on the air with Catherine Herridge in the afternoon when she broke the news that there were no protests outside of that consulate, which the administration had been telling us there were. And by the way, they pushed back on her and said she was wrong. And she stuck by her reporting and she was right. I was on the air when Fox News said that the White House had meddled in those talking points, which they denied on the record. And ultimately, we were proven right on that as well. So Fox News has done some yeoman's work in reporting on Benghazi, but it's not about Fox News. Wemple's got it wrong. It's about the story that these guys are telling. And to suggest that seeing it on the big screen in a picture like this, directed by Michael Bay, is going to have zero impact and is not worthy of any attention, entirely misses the dynamic at play.
Entirely misses the point, because a dramatic movie like this, based on a book that, by the way, this Washington Post columnist said was very good, has the power to bring to life the account of these men who were there and who are passionate about what went wrong. That's why it will have an impact, not because of some Fox News segments. So we can debate about whether Fox News has covered it too much. Certainly, you are right. Most of the mainstream media have decided this is old news, that it's incremental, that people no longer care, and that any new developments are incremental. That is one view, but I don't think this issue can possibly go away completely for Hillary Clinton in this 2016 campaign.
We wouldn't even know. We wouldn't have seen Hillary Clinton's emails to the Egyptian prime minister. We wouldn't have seen her emails to her daughter, which directly contradict the story she told the Benghazi victims, if it hadn't been for the pushing that the media has done on this issue, in particular Fox News. But it's not about Fox News, Chris. It's about the families and the media's desperate desire to move on. Take the issue between Hillary and the families. How did you see that blown up on the cover of all the magazines and all the newspapers? The fact that Hillary essentially suggested that the family members of the dead are lying, and the family members have never wavered, as those three heroes just told me. Who has reason to lie? Who? The family member? Why would they make it up? Charles Woods has contemporaneous notes of his encounter with Hillary moments after he had it.
I think the major thrust of this film hits at the beating heart of this as a concern for Hillary Clinton, which is this. It is unthinkable to most Americans that we would not try, that we would not try to at least rescue that doomed garrison. So then you compound it and you say, well, yes, and then the talking points got doctored, so it left a different impression with people in the election year. And people say, boy, that seems like you're dishonoring. It's a dishonoring. And then you have Hillary Clinton who says, those poor people, they must be mistaken. They must have misremembered. And it is an implicit argument that those people are trying to hurt her politically. And I promise you this. This movie having been out, when whomever the Republicans nominate for president calls Hillary Clinton out on this and stands on a debate stage with her and points at her and says, I'm here on behalf of those families, and I want to say to you what they told me, which is, they're no liars, that's going to be a powerful moment in this election.
Here's the thing. The story has been going on. It's a story of some complexity. And so I think after a while, perhaps, for people who watch television, there's a numbing effect. What this film does and the accounts of these heroic men is that it brings in the human dimension that becomes impossible to ignore and that we can't sometimes always get at in daily journalism.
It's gripping. And it's important, and these guys are important and are American heroes in the truest sense. Great to see you both.
Thanks, Megyn.